Let's take a look at Excel's rank function. How can you rank your values in descending or ascending order? And how can you rank duplicate values without skipping numbers in the sequence? So let's say you have a list of sales managers and their sales numbers. You want to create a report that shows the top three sales managers based on those numbers. Now, two of them have the exact same sales number and they're both number two. You want their names to show up as number two. Then for number three, you want to get the correct name from the table. Ranking is great for grouping your data or bringing order to your data. It's when you want to compare one number to other numbers and see how it ranks in respect. Then in the first example, we're going to be ranking the information in place. So let's say I have this list of sales managers' names and the amount of sales they made. I don't want to change the order of this. I don't want to sort this, but I want to get their rank in a separate column right here. For that, I'm going to use the rank function. Now you're going to see that under rank function, you have a little exclamation mark and it says this function is available for compatibility with Excel 2007 and earlier, and it might be removed in the future. So if you are using Excel 2010 and later, and the people you're going to be sharing your workbook with also have Excel 2010 and later, then I suggest you use this formula because this was introduced since 2010, so was this one, and this one is identical to the original rank function. The average one behaves in a similar way except for duplicate ranks, in the sense that for duplicate ranks, the average rank is returned. So right now, I'm just going to use this one. First argument is the number that I want to get the rank of. That number is right here. Next argument is my reference range. What should it compare it to? My range is right here. I'm going to hold down Control, Shift, and down to highlight this area. I'm going to press F4 to fix the area because I'm planning to pull down the formula and I don't want my comparison range to shift. Now, the last argument is optional. You can see that because it's in square brackets. 0 means descending, 1 means ascending order. And if you leave it out, by default, it's descending order. So in this case, I'm going to leave out that argument. If you wanted it the other way around, you can put a 1 for ascending order. The 2 means that this is the second biggest number in here. So there must be a number that's bigger than that one, and that's this one, right? So William Jones made the highest sales. But check this out. 9,000 doesn't just belong to James Smith, but also to Michael Brown and also to Maria Martin. But where's number 3? Do you see who's number 3? There is no 3 on the list. Instead, we have a number 5. There's also no number 4 on the list. Why? Because we have 3 twos. So what the rank function does is that it skips 3, it skips 4, and it gives a 5 to John Johnson. Now that might be fine depending on your analysis. But what if you wanted to rank duplicates just like you're doing now, but you don't want to skip numbers in between? You actually want John to get a rank of 3. Now here comes a more complicated formula, and surprisingly, it doesn't involve the rank function. I'm actually just going to type in the formula, and if you're interested to find out the engine behind it and you want a bit more explaining, stay tuned to the end and I'll explain that. I'm going to start off with the SUMPRODUCT function. Now right after the bracket, I'm going to open the bracket again. I'm going to compare this number and see, is this number less than or equal to the numbers in this range? I'm going to fix that, close bracket. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide this by the count if my range is this range. So I'm going to check within this range how many times I see this range. Now this part is an array formula, and this might be confusing to say, like, what's happening here? Why are we giving the same arguments for the count if function? But stay tuned to the end and I'm going to explain that. So let's see if this works. I'm going to press enter. I get the count of 2 for that one, which is fine. But here I have the 3. I have another 3 right here, and then I have the 4 here. So I'm not skipping any numbers in the sequence. Now, the great thing about this is, let's say my boss comes to me and says, create a report that has the names of the top three sales managers. And I don't just want to get the first occurrence, right? I want to make sure I include everyone that has number one, include everyone that has number two. And since I have now managed to rank them without skipping numbers in the sequence, I'm going to use this together with another great function. Now, that other great function is an array formula, but it's a very simple one. I'm just going to check if this number equals, let's go back to our data sheet, equals this one, right? Because now it can find 1, 2, and 3. Press F4 to fix it. If that's equal, then what should it give me back? Should give me back the name. And because I'm taking more than one cell in here, I'm referring to ranges, I'm actually creating an array as the outcome. And then we're gonna see how we can tweak this to exactly get what we want. Fix this as well. Now, in the if function, the last argument is value if false. So if I don't come across a 1 there, then what do I want back? And I'm just gonna put nothing here. Close the bracket, I'm gonna press enter. We see nothing here, but when you work with arrays, your best friend is the F9 key, because that's actually gonna show you what's really behind that formula. And we can see empty, 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 and William Jones. And if you remember, William Jones was number one. But how's this gonna help us if we actually can't see William Jones in the cell? Now I'm just gonna press escape to go back, otherwise I'm gonna be overwriting the formula. So we can't see it in the cell, but we're gonna bring it into the cell using another great function that's relatively new. It's in Office 365 and it's called the text join function. Using text join in this way is actually credited to Bill Sizes. I have a video explaining this in detail and I'll put the link to that in the description of this video. What it actually does is that you can combine the text in different columns into one cell. And you can decide what the delimiter of that is. Now in this case, I'm gonna have my final result split by a comma, but you can select any type of delimiter that you want. Now this is the best part of the text join argument, is that you have the ability to ignore empty cells. I remember when I clicked the F9 key on here, we saw William Jones somewhere in the middle, and then we had empty, empty, empty. We actually want to ignore them. And then the last argument is our different text values, and that's actually this array. But because these functions are not programmed CSE functions, what I actually have to do is press Control Shift Enter. Not just Enter, but Control Shift Enter. If I pull this down, I can see all the names split by the delimiter that I defined here in one cell. Now you can see it better here. If I highlight this part of the formula and I press F9, we can see the different names and we can see these empty ones, right? The true means ignore the empty ones and combine the not empty ones with a comma. That's the great advantage of the text join function. Now let's just double check this. Let's just change some things around. Change the 9,000 to 10,000. So James Smith now should be number one, William Jones is number two, and we have Michael Brown and Maria Martin as number three. Control Z to go back. Okay, but I promise you that I'm gonna show you how this part works. So if you've stayed with me so far and you're interested to know why this works, let's get started on that. Well, when you work with complex array formulas, it's always best to put out the steps inside separate cells. So that's what I do personally. I try to visualize the process from the point of view of one single cell. Right here, let's just do the first part where I said, is this number less than or equal to these numbers? Press enter. And remember, what was that great shortcut key that tells us what's behind this? Is the F9 key. So I can see, yes, the first one is true because it is less than or equal to itself. Then this number is bigger than this number, so it's a false, right? So all of this is from the point of view of this number right here. Now, this is difficult to read, so I'm gonna press enter. Now, I'm just gonna highlight the area here and click inside the formula and press Control shift enter. This is going to put the right value in the correct position. So I can always compare, okay, this number is false because this number is less than that number, right? This is true because 9,000 is equal to 9,000. It's just easier to follow your formula this way. Now, the next thing I did is to do that weird count if formula. I looked at the range, which is this one, and I compared it to the entire range. So my criteria was identical to that. Now, what do we get behind this? We get how many times each number occurs in the entire range. So 3 means 9,000 has occurred 3 times, which is correct. The next number, 6,750, has occurred 2 times, and so on. So this part of the formula doesn't change. When we're dragging this thing down here, this count if part always stays the same. The part that changes is this one, because I'm always comparing that number to the rest. So now let's also bring this part vertically so we can compare it better. Now we have them in the same order as our sales data. What did I do next is that I divided the true with this number here. And the moment you do something with true and false values, Excel translates true to a 1 and false to a 0. So check this out. I divide true by a 3, I get a number. I pull this down, I get a 0, because false becomes a 0 because of that division. Now let's just push this all the way down. Now what's the sum of this? It's a 2. That's our number here. So all of this is actually done from the point of view of this one number here. Now, where does sum product function come in? Well, we're just using it as a container. We're using the sum part of it to go through these and add the values up. And because we don't want to press Control Shift Enter, we're going to use that function. Now, you can do this from the point of view of another cell. So let's say we want to take a look at this one right here, and we want to do this analysis for Robert Williams. So all I have to do is highlight this. I'm going to press F9. I'm going to copy this, but be careful, press Escape to leave. Otherwise, we're going to leave that inside the formula. Now I'm going to paste and Control Shift Enter. So that changes the rest of our array here. And if I highlight this, I get a 4. So that whole thing is from the point of view of this cell right here. Right, so that's the mechanics of this formula. And that's how you can do the different ranks, the usual simple rank, and the other rank that doesn't skip numbers, but actually doesn't include the rank formula itself. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you enjoy watching videos like this one and you want to learn a bit more about Excel, do subscribe to this channel. See you in the next video.